Hey guys, welcome back to Python Course for Kids. Mohammed is speaking from T-Squared Technical Talk YouTube channel, and this is our 7th episode in this course, Function and Loops in Python. After we completed last video, Rock, Paper, Scissors, Coding with If Statement, and exercised heavily all the 4 if statement types, simple if else, if else, and if else, else. Now, you are ready for a new subject in programming with Python. Actually, it is 2 main concepts in programming, not 1. Function and loops. But because they are so related to each other, we preferred to explain both concepts together, side by side, so you can feel similarities and differences between them. We will explain the main purpose of function in programming and its structure in Python. Also, we will see the loop's meaning and types in Python. This video is the first video in function and loops subject, as it will be followed with many programming practices videos. Please know that the concepts which I'm going to explain in this episode have some backgrounds from our previous videos. So throughout this video, you will find the links to previous videos are tagged in the top right corner of the screen. And also, you can find all the links in the description section below. While this video is narrated in English, you still have Arabic and Spanish subtitles to use. But before we start the video, please don't forget to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and turn on the notification bell to receive automatic notifications of all the new videos from our channel. Let's get started! To give you a better meaning of loops, I have a story to share to you. This is me, Mohammed, and that man right there is my father. He likes to fix things in our house, from appliances to using walls to decorate, like hanging things, painting, plumbing, and carpentry. But to do that, my dad needs all the tools he has. Every time I see what he fixes, I'm always amazed by how good it can be. Daddy taught me all the tools, names, and purposes, so I can help him fixing the stuff. One time, my dad was fixing something as usual. He had Mohammed. I came to him ready to help doing anything. "Please get the manual screwdriver," Dad said. I went as fast as Flash to get him the manual screwdriver and run back like Flash. "Next, please get the drill," he asked it, and again, me, vroom, vroom. "Please get the wrench," and vroom, vroom. "And finally, please get the pillars," and lastly, vroom, vroom. Mission completed. Thanks, Mohammed. Dad thanked me. I'm happy. The next day, Mohammed, Dad called me. "Oh no, again." "Well, I have an idea. Using function in Python." And this process happens every time, the same way, in the same sequence. This kind of reminds me of a function in programming. If we have a toolbox, and I list all the tools inside in the same sequence how my dad calls for them, so I can go and get it one time instead of running back and forth every day like what I did with my dad. See how that would save time and effort of searching for each tool and running to get them? Same in programming. Imagine that a zip bag and we kept our code lines inside in the same sequence as we execute it. Then we zip the bag and label it with a function name. That represents the purpose and usage of this function. This is a sample of a function that draws a line in x and y axis. Based on the slope and intersection with y axis. In programming, we write function code only one time. Then using function by mentioning its name is calling the function. It's like when you call someone to do something for you. So every time when we want to use it, we will just call it with different slope and interception values. And the function will do all the job for us without repeating any code. Isn't that amazing? Ahmed also had a very nice graphical demonstration on function concept in our second episode. The link is shown on the right corner of the screen now. Please watch it as well. This is how we write function in Python. Easy peasy. It is just writing def or definition, and then following that with the function name and two parentheses, where you define your inputs to the function. Next lines will be the function code. Hadn't you noticed that the multiple spaces before the function lines of code? If you remember that Ahmed explained in the rock, paper, scissors video, this concept in programming, that is called indention. Four spaces or more in the beginning of a line is called an indention. You could watch Ahmed's video on the link shown at the right corner of the screen now. Last line of code in the function might be the return line, where you can define the result if your function is designed to return something. After executing it, it's code like number or text or even object. This might be confusing to you now, but don't worry, I'll explain to you that concept several times in the course. When we call that function, we just write the name of the function followed with the parentheses and the input values, as well as the function expects inputs or assign it to a variable if the function has the return value. Functions are great for many reasons. First, not repeating code lines, as functions allow the same piece of code to run multiple times without repeating the code lines, which means less number of code lines. Second, since copying and pasting code perhaps result in human mistakes like runtime errors that we explained and faced on our previous episode, link is shown at the right corner of the screen now. Using functions shall improve your coding and minimize such kind of errors occurred due to copy and paste. Third, when you create a function and test it, you do not need to test it again every time you use it or call it. Fourth, and organize your code. Functions break longer programs up to smaller components, and that what makes your code more easier to find errors in your program and more easier to read. This is just like the difference between those pictures of the toys. The picture on the left is messy, making it harder to find your toys. And the one in the right hand is organized, where you could easily find your toys and enjoy it. Finally, and fifth, the magic of reusing. When you organize your code in functions, you will be able easily to reuse it again in your new projects, or even share it with your friends. However, functions don't resolve another issue of repeating code for certain times or till certain actions. This is called loops. Let's see what loops mean. Repeat something in programming is called loop. Loops mainly have two types, either for loops that depend on count or number or repetitions, or while loops that repeat itself till a condition or event to stop it. What does it mean? Let me give you those examples. When my dad goes to the supermarket, he has a list of items that mom has prepared for him. Let's say the list has 25 items. Daddy will keep shopping in the supermarket till finished the 25 items, and only after that I can leave the supermarket. And here is me doing my homework. I have math, so social study and science to do today. Three subjects. I'll not consider myself finished my homework till finishing the three assigned subjects. Do you remember this game? In this race, you keep playing till you finish 21 laps. Could you observe the common between all those cases? It is the numbers. In each case, we repeat the same actions. Acting like shopping in my dad's case, or doing my homework in my case, or playing video game car race in your case. And we will stop that only after finishing certain number of repetitions. Now let's see the other case of while loop. When you play chess with your friend, numbers of moves don't matter at all. You keep playing till one of you succeeded to make the checkmate move. Also, your mom gives you the lunch. No matter how many times or forks you eat, you keep eating till you finish your whole plate. Also, when daddy play a movie for us to watch, it doesn't matter how many minutes that movie will last, we'll keep watching till we see the end on the screen that the movie is considered as finished. Here, the common thing between all cases is the stop event, checkmate, finishing the plate, or seeing the end screen. You can think of while loops as you are repeating the same action infinitely till pressing the stop button. So, the question that may come to your mind now is which technique shall I use in each situation? Shall I use functional loops? And if it is a loop, what kind of loops shall I use? Well, there is a way to find that out using the flowchart way. To remind you what a flowchart is, please watch our video in the link shown in the top of the screen now. Flowchart is a step-by-step chart that has basic shapes, like building blocks. Every block has a meaning. An oval shows the start or the end of your problem solving. Our main problem here is the selection of the best technique that suits each situation, function, or loop to use. Okay, we will start asking ourselves a question. Question shape in flowchart is a diamond block. Remember it with the question mark box of Super Mario. Okay, first question is, are you grouping the code lines or using it in many locations in your program? Please note here that questions in flowchart are always yes or no questions. So if the answer is yes, I want to group these code lines for using them in many locations in my program. So function is selected choice. See here, rectangle shape in flowchart means action. The action here is a choice and use of function technique. Remember that a function is like a group of code lines, packed in a zipper bag and ready for being called or used many times in your program. Now, if the answer is no, which means I want to repeat using my group of code lines in one location only in my program, then I choose loops instead of function. No answer would lead to another question. As we said, try to remember that question is a diamond shape, like Super Mario question block. The question here is, do you know for how many times you'll need to repeat your group of code lines before starting your loop? If the answer is yes, means I know the exact numbers of repetitions, and then you select for loops kind. But if the answer is no, means I don't know exactly for how many repetitions my code shall be looped. Then you choose while loops type, where you want to repeat the code till an event will press the stop button for you and prevent code from further repetitions. Now the big competition between two programming superheroes concepts, function and loops. Ding, 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 ding. Comparing between two things doesn't mean someone is better than the other, but looking for the similarities and differences between them. Here we have lime and lemon. Both are citrus, but they have different color, size, and even different taste. Comparing is like distinguishing between big and small, slow and fast, more and less. Now let's see the similarities and differences between function and loops and programming. In terms of location, which means where in your program you want the repetition or reuse of the grouping code lines, a loop is used in only one location. One function can be reused or called as many times as you want in your program. Reuse, the idea of exporting and reusing the same group of code lines in other locations in the same program or other programs without rewriting them, not copy and paste. This is not applicable for loops, but it is the main idea behind functions. Repetition, when we repeat code lines in loops, number of repetitions in for loops is determined by a number, and in while loops is determined by stop event as explained. On the other hand, number of times reusing or calling a function depends only on the number of calls programming decides. Variables. In general, there are two types in variables in Python, local and global. In previous videos, Kareem explained the meaning of variables in programming, and Ahmed explained variable scope concept as well. The links shown at the right corner of the screen now. Please watch them. However, don't worry, we will explain them again while exercising functions and loops together. Inside loops, global variables are used only, but in functions, both types of local and global are used. Finding the return feature. Think of return as the result of mass function. 8 squared equals 64. 64 is the return of the square function. Return feature is not applicable in loops. However, it is optional for functions. Well, this is the end. We succeeded to give you a full introduction to function and loops concepts in programming. Now let's have a rest. And Dad will eat popcorn and run a movie. But before that, I want to summarize what we have learned in this episode. In this video, we gave you a very nice story about the repetition of action in our life and how is that done in programming through function and loops. We learned 1. Why we need function. 2. Function structure and advantages. 3. Loops, meaning and types. 4. When to use function and when to use loops. 5. Similarities and differences between function and loops. Finally, it is highly recommended that you watch this video many times to grasp all the ideas in it. And also, the exercise with us all upcoming coding videos to fully understand how to apply those cornerstone programming concepts. Let us know if you have any question in the description section below. And don't forget to like this video, subscribe to our channel, turn on the notification bell to receive automatic notifications of all the new videos from our channel, and watch previous videos. Thanks, and see you in the next video.